Fox Health Center. We're updating you once again on a major winter storm affecting the eastern half of the country. Anywhere from Boston to Atlanta, there will be problems on the roadways and at the airports. But first, we want to take you to Southern California. Around Los Angeles, there was an earthquake this morning. A strong earthquake occurred 20 miles southwest of San Fernando in California at 4:31 local time. The magnitude was computed at 6.6 on the Richter scale, and the earthquake was felt from San Diego to Las Vegas. The video you're looking at here around Los Angeles and Ventura was filmed soon after the earthquake, so before dawn this morning. Didn't take long before fires were erupted as gas lines were ruptured with the earthquake. And we continue to have fires reported around the Los Angeles area. Now up to 10 deaths from the earthquake, 4 from heart attacks. Now in Sylmar, you're looking at 40 homes that have been reported severely damaged or destroyed, mainly on fire due to the earthquake. They may be expecting aftershocks anywhere from a week to a month from now due to this earthquake. You're looking at West LA, where the Santa Monica Freeway in Los Angeles has collapsed. An intersection of two major freeways in the San Fernando Valley, Interstates 5 and 14, known locally as the Golden State and the Antelope Valley freeways. Also, a freeway bridge was reported damaged on State Route 118 in the Simi Valley Freeway, that is. We'll continue to update you on the earthquake. We also, however, want to update you on the latest major winter storm in the east. If you're flying in and out of any of the airports in the east today, bring a good book and hopefully bring some winter clothes with you, because it is going to be very cold following this storm and delays are extensive, especially at Newark. Take a look at that, 255 minutes, that is. And some airports are actually closed. Louisville has had over a foot of snow, and they actually started with ice last night, so the airport at this time is closed. And there will be major delays up and down the eastern seaboard, as you can see. White, of course, is snow. Orange indicates where there is ice, and we are getting reports of ice mixing in anywhere from New Jersey down to the suburbs around Atlanta, where travel is just treacherous, and it's probably going to get worse before it gets better, especially here in the Northeast. You're looking at the radar here. Around Boston and New York, they are reporting snow at this time. As you get down into New Jersey, it's starting to mix with some sleet and some freezing rain. Newark still reporting snow, but most of the major cities here in the Northeast can expect a mix. Snow and perhaps some sleet and freezing rain, like they are getting now in Philadelphia and in Baltimore and in D.C. And then snow to follow in the cold air. Here's your snow history, showing you where the snow has been heaviest. Lighter amounts up towards Minneapolis to Green Bay, but as it headed down through parts of Kentucky and West Virginia, southern Ohio, we've had reports of more than a foot of snow, and there's more snow on the way. Take a look at your snowfall forecast now. The tail end of the snow now in Ohio and in Kentucky, and the heavier stuff still expected in the Northeast. So where you see the white on the map, as much as a foot of snow, if not more, expected as the storm system moves on out. So through the rest of this afternoon and tonight, traffic will be very, very slow. Heavy snow, a mixture along the coast, and then ice in the deep south. Around Charlotte, around Asheville, and down to Atlanta, the ice continues. And as I mentioned, now reporting ice around D.C., Baltimore, and Philadelphia. We'll continue to update you on this major winter storm in the east and the earthquake in Los Angeles every half hour. Now we want to take you back to the studio where Tom Moore has the forecast.